us here, and welcome to episode of Space Engineers. And that seems to be a bit of a weird problem. Okay. Yeah, constant waving for some reason. Strange. Anyway, today I'm taking a look at two mods. The Zepplin and Controller revamp by Phil the Thrill. As you may have noticed, we might actually be on it already. And also the RB Ravenbolt Compact Weapon Systems by Ravenbolt. Now what do these add? Well, the revamp mod basically reintroduced the Zepplin balloon, which we already did some time ago, as well as the controller systems to make it easier to manage. As for the compact weapon system, it just adds 4 new turrets for both small and large ships. However, due to the nature of things, I can't shoot the large. No, the small. Why? Because we're traveling at quite a considerable speed. So, you see up there. Whoa! Ow! Might have been helpful if I actually had the inertia dampeners or whatever active. There we go. That'll help. See, these are the Zeppelin balloons. The more hydrogen gas they have inside them, the higher your ship will go. However, the heavier your ship, the more you'll need. And due to it going over the horizon, it's actually rotating downwards. It is pretty cool. I got a driver right there. I was wondering where the driver was. And as for what's under this thing, oh dear. Well, this is a blueprint linked on the mod page for the Zeppelin mod, for this revamp. So you'll get to try out this example ship yourself. I think it'd be pretty cool to actually make, well, putting these turrets here gave me a fun idea. Like, get multiple teams, or multiple groups per team, and have all of these ships, paint them whatever color they want, and then have these compact turrets attached to them, and then they go and shoot each other down. I think it'd be pretty cool. Yee. That'd be fun to do. I'm actually set that up. Not sure if I can get enough people though. Oh well. The world will only have 2 mods, so it shouldn't be that much of an issue. But there's also, there's only been survival mode, no, creative mode. Yee. Anyway. Now that we take a look at those, how about we take a look at the 4 turrets? I'm changing altitude. Let's do that now. Now you see with the controller, it's set up so that commands can change the altitude. It's set up to drop Zeppelin at various meters. I'm not sure if that's something you can do just via yield modules. Like this? Oh no. Ah, it must be on the it's on the cockpit. It showed. Yeah, the controller adds these to your Zeppelin. It's actually pretty handy things. Adds a Zeppelin control. Ooh. Now I just need to remove that one. Because I don't want to mess something up. Now where's it? Ah, there's the Zeppelin control. And this is the altitude. Where you can set it all the way up here. Not only that, it's based on sea level, its altitude. So all these mountains won't really do, well, won't change the altitude because of these mountains. You have to manually change that. Thanks to this handy little LCD setup in front of us, we know how close we are. That's if we have the hood turned off. So how about we go up a few meters? Here we go. You see, we are now rising in altitude. How about we head this way? In fact. Now let's drop instead. Let's do 2,000. And now it's gonna change it, which direction it's going. Still going sideways. Oh well. Yeah, that little flame there is actually burning off hydrogen. It's a new block that's added with the mod. Its purpose is to reduce the altitude. So you can't just go wide by going up and down. I didn't even take a look at how you meant to set it up. That's not good. I'll be right back. It's a lot simpler than I thought. There's no complicated stuff to do. Because all the things are controlled by this thing! Also, I didn't know you had to change these things now. I think it's back in a second. Now, the way to set it up, once you have the cockpit placed, every single time you put down hydrogen tank, Zeppelin tank, oxygen generator, as well as a vent, you simply go into here, click on update Zeppelin setup. And this lets you choose the altitude here. And that lets you set the current altitude, which I think you do and think, but that lets you run the setup automatically. In case things change and you don't want to go into the menu, you just press the button and there you go. Not sure what that was meant to be, but oh well. Huh. Oh. I'm not actually sure what that does. Press it. Okay. This is happening. So yeah, making a Zeppelin is actually really easy. But the heavier your ship is, the more Zeppelin tanks you're gonna need, otherwise it won't float. So yeah, if you wanna make something really big, you need an awful lot of them. So anyway, how about we move on to the weapons? Which we have right over here. We got this thing, the compact Gatling turret, which is right here. Do the little thing. Camera. Then we got the compact Gatling turret T4, which is a bit bigger. And then we have the compact missile turret, which is all over here. But why does this book have to be so slow? Knee. I don't have it there. It's got quite a few missiles on it. Shoots 6 per side. Hold on. And the last one is this one. Compact interior turret. As well. It's right there. I think this one actually has conveyors on it. Let's find out. Yeah. They all have conveyors right at the bottom there. Not only that, available for small ships too. That's large, small. Small, and small. But that requires the smaller conveyor port though, for the small ships. But yeah, you can have ammo automatically conveyed into them for all four designs. That. Large, small. Can't see the turrets on them though. So anyway, how about I show you them shooting? I think I've come up with my own design of Zeppelin when it comes to the Zeppelin battle. Mainly just to include some extra seats in a protected area. Anyway, let's see. Go here. Now we get this one. And control. Now this is the one with the smaller barrel. As you can see. And boom. Gotta shoot down people's Zeppelins with this. I wonder if the tanks explode if you shoot them. Not right now. Do that later. Now for the T4, which is the long turret. And that's really going to do some damage. Not sure if this is actually moving the thing around. Let's see. And now, the missile launcher. Granted, having the missile launcher on the back is kind of an odd choice. But oh well, considering. Even if you shoot it backwards, it's still going the same direction as you. Or not. I guess that's only when you're going to get max speed. Once we fired off all the shots, and there we go, reloading. And now for the interior turrets. Which are good for close range, I'm guessing. And there you go. It'd be kind of fun having several Zeppelins flying around shooting each other. Whee! So that's all those. Now, as for their build cost, probably wouldn't notice as I was going through them. Not too much. About 10 steel plates, 25 construction components, no, 30 construction components, 5 grids, 5 or 6 small steel tubes, 4 motors, and 10 computers. The missile launcher and the interior turrets are the only ones with differences to the other two. We thought the small steel tube count would have changed. You know, due to the size of the barrels. It's 12 large steel tubes for the missiles. That's about the only change. Oh, and the missile launcher requires another 10 additional construction components. 2 more computers. Twice as many motors, and only 2 metal grids. The interior turret requires a lot less, so it's a bit cheaper and easy to get. So yeah, I'll have links to both these mods in the description below. Oh, the reason why the LCD isn't there because I crashed this ship. I just put it back in. I went down too fast. Right into a mountain. So yeah, I should really get working on the Zeppelin for the battle. Yeah, that'd be cool. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, please leave a like and even subscribe for episodes. And I shall see you all next time. Bye-bye.